Considerable shortages have appeared everywhere today. Commodities are rising higher and higher. Prices are escalating and wages are stagnant. The Fed has suggested this is only temporary and that it's simply just a bump in the road. What will come of all of this? You came here for the truth, so let me unveil that for you. Today, we are going to talk about shortages. That's the big one. I want to cover this in all aspects. I'm going to show you the prices that are rising. I'm going to show you what's happening today. I'm going to look at this from all angles. I've got a lot of GPS insights that I need to get to. Let's begin right away. I wanted to begin today by talking about what's happening with steel. I've covered lumber, I've covered just about everything else, and I'll show you some of those, but steel is one very important commodity, and a bubble could be brewing in steel stocks. You could see that, of course, the industry of steel was brought to its knees, forcing manufacturers to shut down production as they struggled to survive the imploding economy. But as the recovery got underway, mills were slow to resume production, and that created a massive steel shortage. You're seeing this just about everywhere right now, of course. Quote, this is going to be short-lived. It's very appropriate to call this a bubble. Then they also say the correction will be very intense. It's just a matter of when and how it happens. Is this going to be a whole thing that all of these different companies are going to start falling? All of these different commodities are going to start correcting? Right now, the trend is definitely up, up, and away. There's more in here. I think that we should always be looking at as much of the detail as we can. This is a chart that you should know. Steel shortage is lifting stocks. They give you some examples comparing that to the S&P 500. Now understand, the S&P 500 has performed very well this year, and of course, since March 2020. But you could see right here, it's 11.5%. For the S&P 500. That's fantastic in a historic sense, but look at it compared to the steel companies, US Steel being one example, 53.5% right there, and others going even higher. So there is very serious froth, as they call it right here, and apparently this is on an unsustainable level. But that's up to you to decide, of course. Many people are still pouring their money into the stocks. They are also getting into the commodities themselves. So that's up to you to decide what is a fair value, what is the proper valuation today, but understand what's happening. That's the first point you got to make. I want to make this very clear right now. You have to get on the insiders before we move on. This is important because the insiders, which is available at themoneygps.com, is going to be the way that I get around all of the shadow banning and so on. I'm going to email you every single day this video, the daily video. That's all it is for now. Eventually, I'm going to put content around and I'm going to make an actual newsletter. But for the time being, this is simply a way for me to get directly to you without the middleman, if you know what I'm talking about. The chip shortage keeps getting worse. Why can't we just make more? That's what people are asking. Look, we got a shortage of lumber. We got a shortage of this and that. Hey, just make some more. But it's not so easy. I'm going to expand on that in the GPS insights in a moment here. But here they're talking about semiconductors. Understand that semiconductors are in everything today, whether we like it or not. These chips are just about everywhere. And of course, if there's a shortage, that's going to impact certain companies, certain sectors, and of course, you as an individual. Shortages of semiconductors are battering automakers and tech giants, raising alarm bells from Washington to Brussels to Beijing. The crunch has raised the fundamental question for policymakers, consumers, and investors. Why can't we just make more chips? There is both a simple answer and a complicated one. The simple version is that making chips is incredibly difficult and getting tougher. I would highly recommend checking this article out. It goes into depth, so much depth, in fact, about how the process of making a chip actually comes to be. And they give you the, you know, really good infographics and all of that. Highly, highly recommend taking a look if you have a moment. While the semiconductors are extremely important and front and center, not just for me, but I'm sure for you as well, it's going all over the place. Look at this. A nationwide shortage of pool products is making chlorine tablets and propane tanks hard to come by and increasing prices right as the summer months approach. In this heat, if you don't take care of your pool properly, you will have algae. And of course, that's going to be a big problem. You don't want a swamp, you want to be swimming in a pool. They doubled the price. The consumer doesn't want to pay for that. So it's affecting everything. It's affecting everything. It's not like you got a choice for certain things. When food prices are rising, sure, you can, you know, change things here and there. You could decide not to buy that, but that's not, living at a cost of living particular standard that, you know, you've become accustomed to. You have to lower your standards every time. So you're not even able to not necessarily have things that are so fantastic and you know, luxurious. You're just trying to live a normal life and the prices keep rising. Of course, that is a big issue, particularly those people who aren't making 7 and 8 figures and beyond. This is gonna have a big impact on their finances. And then we go a step deeper. Chicken wings are flying off the shelves. That's right. After a year promoting takeout wings and crispy chicken sandwiches, restaurants including KFC, Wingstop, Buffalo Wild Wings said that they are paying steep prices for scarce poultry. They're running out of limiting sales of tenders, fillets, and wings, cutting into some of the most reliable sales. So suddenly, they're in a big issue as well. And understand, this is going widespread. Just about every industry is being affected by this, including physical precious metals. Look at the price of soybeans. Look at the price of copper. Look at everything today, and it's skyrocketing. And that, of course, brings me to the Money GPS Insights. So here we are in the Money GPS Insights, and I want to talk about this chip shortage, and of course that expands into other sectors and avenues as well. The number one thing is that you cannot simply turn around a factory in a short period of time. That's really the key here. That's what we need to understand, that yes, if there are shortages, it's not as if you snap your fingers and you're able to turn around these factories, build them up. There is a whole long process involved here, and that Bloomberg article covers it in depth. Okay, now we're talking about number two, and that is companies that are able to build up and actually increase their capacity right now are going to win these big contracts with the big players, the big boys who've got the money, who need these chips, these semiconductors, and of course there's high demand. So you know there is incentive today for companies to do that. So there's going to be some companies that are going to capitalize on all of this. So as an investor, keep that in mind. And then we have number three. You also have to understand the raw materials. The raw materials used in these chips are going to also be in high demand. If you figure out what is going into these chips, then you can see what type of commodities are going to benefit. And that means maybe an ETF, that means the futures, that means companies that are mining these commodities, or maybe some way, somehow in the supply chain affected by that price, you can also benefit from what's happening today. So we have the markets, of course, rising to new highs all the time. And what's been happening here? There's this obvious trend, the markets, the algorithms, the analysts, and of course, the central banks are all working together in sync. Today's read is another proof point that we are one step closer to full economic recovery sooner than some may expected. As we see some serious momentum building on the jobs front, all eyes will be on how this plays into the action taken by the Fed, if any. So essentially what they're saying is we have to monitor how well the economy does, because when it does well officially, the Federal Reserve might start increasing interest rates, and that's the time when we start to get cautious about our investing. And that is important to note, of course, as an investor, because you can see the risk on today. That mentality is clearly in full effect. So that's when things start to become a little bit more, let's say, cautious, a little bit more risky because of the Fed withdrawing support. This piece of news right here almost slipped through the cracks. You didn't see it on the front page anywhere, but let me tell you, it's here at the Money GPS. Fed warns about potential for significant declines in asset prices as valuations climb. So in one hand, they're telling you something. In the other, they're giving you the truth. Now, this came from the Fed Governor Brainard, but essentially saying, quote, asset prices may be vulnerable to significant declines should risk appetite fall. Ah, how would that happen? Well, I think it's pretty obvious that the risk appetite is directly correlated to the interest rates and to the money printing. Here, they go on to say much of the similar factors, but at the bottom there is what we need to note, and I'll pull out the highlighter for you. Vulnerabilities associated with elevated risk appetite are rising. Valuations across a range of asset classes have continued to rise from levels that were already elevated late last year. That's right, it has gone way beyond that. The combination of stretch valuations with very high levels of corporate indebtedness bear watching because of the potential to amplify the effects of a, check this out, repricing event. Don't say correction. Don't say crash. Don't use those words because the algorithms pick that up. You see? You see how smart they are? They've learned. A repricing event. Of course, repricing down is what they're talking about, but don't say that. Come on. Come on. That's negative. That's negative. Don't be a pessimist, okay? Don't be a pessimist. Call it a repricing event. Use any propaganda you want. I'm sure George Orwell will be absolutely happy about what you're saying. Really quickly, wanted to note this right here. You can see gold investment demand. That's what we were talking about before with the semiconductors. That's part of it. You look at what has been happening. There are multiple levels to this. There's the bar and coin demand. There's the ETFs and similar products. And of course, there's investment. That is just showing you the overall what has been happening. And it's always going to be in flux. But I do believe that the physical metals are completely and entirely separated from that investment demand. You look at it, people, they purchase it in a way that's completely different than, you know what the financial advisors and this and that do. It's totally different situation. Bar and coin demand split, physical bar demand, official coin, metals, and imitation coin, and you look at total bar and coin demand. And that has been rising recently because more people are seeing that this is something that I should be putting my money in. It's physical, it's different. Don't look at the prices. It's completely separate. But I just wanted to note that because, of course, this is used in technology. This is used in these semiconductors. It's in your cell phones. It's in your cars. It's all over the place. So people should be paying attention to that. And of course, silver is in here as well, as there's more solar panels, as there's more all of these different new technologies or newer technologies that are coming out. You have to understand that demand is absolutely there. If you found this video informative, hit that like button, hit that thumbs up button. That's how you support me. If you want to learn about e-commerce for free, I have a course for you, the Amazon GPS.com. If you want to learn about the financial system, you can check that out at my website, themoneygps.com, or you can also just go to the link in the description. And if you haven't seen the video already, click it right here and you'll get to it. Take care, and I'll see you on the next one.